Hello, everyone. My name is Andrew.
And I'm Kassy.
And this is the Culips English Podcast. Hello there, everyone. Welcome back to Culips. This episode is a simplified speech episode. Simplified speech is the series that features clear, natural, and easy to understand conversations that we design to help you boost your English listening skills and increase your knowledge of essential English vocabulary, and of course, help you to become a better English speaker. And today I'm joined by Kassy, my co-host. Hey there, Kassy.
Hey, Andrew. How's it going?
It's going pretty well, but today's topic is not one that I'm in love with, to be honest with you. How do you feel about our topic today, Kassy?
Yeah, I'm not a big fan either. What is our topic today, Andrew?
Well, our episode title is Are You Afraid of the Dentist? And that's what we are going to talk about, visiting the dentist and getting your teeth checked out. And the reason why we are talking about this topic is because we received a message from one of our Brazilian listeners who is a dentist. Her name is Dr. Alexandra Shreen. And Alexandra wrote, "Hello, Andrew. I'm a huge fan of Culips. These podcasts are simply the best. I'm Brazilian and I like to practice my English with you because I used to travel abroad 3 times every year, I guess probably before COVID. So it's pretty important for me to communicate with foreign people. I'm a dentist and you guys come with me in my car, sitting by my side every day while I'm driving to my dental office." Cool. So Kassy, did you know that we are in a Brazilian car right now?
That is pretty cool.
That is pretty cool. I wish I was there in reality. But anyway, Alexandra goes on to write, "I'd like to suggest the topic for Culips, which is fear of the dentist. And thank you for everything." So thank you for suggesting this topic, Alexandra. It is a good one. And I'm sorry that Kassy and I have a negative outlook on going to the dentist, but it's true.
I think she expects it.
Yes, perhaps. So we'll get into this topic in just a moment here, everyone. But before we do, I want to let you know that there is a study guide available for this episode for all Culips members. And we recommend studying along with the guide while you listen to us here today. And in the guide, you'll find a transcript, detailed definitions and examples of some of the key vocabulary that you'll hear Kassy and I use. There's a quiz. There's lots of good stuff in the study guides. So to download it, just visit culips.com. And if you're not a Culips member yet, but you would like to check out the study guides and see what they're like, there are some samples, some free samples on our website. So if you go to culips.com and then check out the study guide samples option, you can actually download 6 study guides for free. So if you're new to Culips or you're just interested in what our study guides are like, then please check those free ones out. Kassy, maybe we already gave away our answer to this question, but are you afraid of the dentist?
In the past, I was very afraid of the dentist, and now I just find it very inconvenient to go there.
Okay, so the name, there is a special word that it's not a common word in English, but it is a word that exists, which is dentophobia. And this means fear of going to the dentist. So, Kassy, I guess in the past you experienced some dentophobia.
Yes, that's correct. Andrew, do you have dentophobia?
I don't have dentophobia per se, and I don't think I've ever been afraid of going to the dentist, but it's always been uncomfortable for me. I have some bad memories, not bad memories, but just uncomfortable memories of visiting the dentist when I was younger. And I think there are two parts of it for me, because although Canada has healthcare, a good healthcare system that is public and paid for by tax dollars, we don't have a public dental care system, which is so stupid. I don't know why in Canada we have a public healthcare system, which is pretty good, but then dental is private and it's kind of like every man for themselves. And it's very expensive to go to the dentist in Canada, actually. So I think part of my negative association with going to the dentist is that it was always a scary financial thing, either for my family when I was younger, or once I became an independent adult, then it was like, oh no, I got a cavity. Ah, how can I pay for that? How can I afford that? Because it's not cheap to get it fixed. So part of the reason for my negativity about going to the dentist is partially due to financial stress. And now I don't really need to worry about that, now that I'm not a poor student anymore, but still that in the back of my mind going on. And then also, I mean, we can get into this in a moment here as well, but when I was 13, 14, 15, somewhere in there, I had braces, which were really uncomfortable. And I always hated going to get my braces tightened, and they would cut my mouth, and it was just not fun at all. So that was a painful time in my life for a couple of years, having my braces on. And so I think those two factors combined together just give me a pessimistic attitude when it comes to going to the dentist.
I think another thing is that dental care is one of the few preventative things that still hurt, right? So dental care is meant to prevent future pain. Like, you're cleaning your teeth now so that you don't get really horrible cavities and necessary root canals in the future. However, when you go to the dentist to get, you know, that scaling, that teeth cleaning, it still hurts because, you know, your gums might be sensitive and they're scratching little metal picks against your mouth or against your teeth and your gums. So preventative measures in medicine are usually, you know, like exercising, diet, more sleep. Like, they're annoying, but they're not painful usually. But the dentist, even if you have perfect teeth, it still hurts a little bit.
Yeah, that's a very interesting perspective. I've never thought of that before, but yeah, I think you're completely right. It's also that, you know, you're on a chair that reclines and you're usually put into a position where you can't really see what's happening, and that can be frightening. And the tools, they make those weird high-pitched sounds, like the drill sound is something that even is making me shiver just a little bit thinking about it. So I think for all of these reasons, it's kind of natural to have a fear of going to the dentist. And I know many people have this fear. Now, I should say that although I don't enjoy going to the dentist, it's something that I don't look forward to doing at all. I still do it. I still go to the dentist when I need to. And that actually reminds me, I got a text from my dentist this week saying it's time to go in for a checkup. So I'll have to book that appointment. Kassy, have you ever had any major dental work done? I mean, your teeth look very good.
Yeah, I was very, very, very lucky, or I guess I had really good parents. who took me to the dentist religiously. Mm-hmm. I did not have even a single cavity until I came to Korea when I was 22. Yeah.
Wow. So you managed to go through all of your baby teeth with no cavities. Perfect set of baby teeth. That's good. Mm-hmm. And then all the way until you were 22. Wow, that's amazing. I had my first cavity when I was like 5, maybe. I was pretty young, maybe 6. Yeah.
I also never had braces, and I've only had one wisdom tooth pulled.
Wow.
I've been very lucky. I was born with one less tooth on the left side, though. So I had and still have a gap in my teeth.
Oh, interesting.
But it's very small, so it's not too annoying.
Okay. Yeah, well, you're lucky that you were born with straight teeth. Mm-hmm. Might be my British genes. I'm not sure that I had crooked teeth as a teenager. At least I remember it being, at this time in my life, one of my canine teeth, which is one of the teeth to the side of your mouth. And for me, it was the top one, came in crooked and a little bit on top, overlapping some of my other teeth, or probably only one of my other teeth. I don't think it was that big of a problem. But that's why I had braces. If I recall correctly, my teeth were just too tight on that side, and so there wasn't room for that tooth to come down into its natural spot. So the braces actually created a gap where that tooth could come in. And yeah, so that was not a fun experience, having to wear braces for several years and a retainer after that. That was the biggest dental work that I've ever had done. Other than that, nothing major. I haven't had like a root canal or dental surgery, oral surgery, or haven't had my wisdom teeth removed.
Wow, we both haven't. That's interesting.
Yeah, the dentist said it wasn't a priority for me, that it didn't have to be done. And so I wasn't going to volunteer to sign up for that.
I totally understand why you wouldn't.
Yeah, so.
Andrew, I have a question about your dental experience as a kid.
Okay.
In America, you know, they would check your teeth and polish them, you know, take off the plaque that's hanging between your gums and your teeth. But at the end of the visit, they would, in America at least, give us this weird gel that was like a fluoride for your teeth.
Uh-huh.
And it came in a variety of flavors. Grape, bubblegum, mint, orange. And they tried to make it sound so cool with the various flavors, but it was always torture.
Yeah, I remember that. And I remember the flavor of it. Like, I would always choose the bubblegum flavor. Mm-hmm. And yeah, I don't exactly remember what that was. Kassy, I think you're right that it's probably like a fluoride coating that they would put over our teeth at the very end. I always thought that was really weird, like how they tell you, the dentist and your parents, everybody says, don't chew gum, it causes cavities. And then you go to the dentist and they're like, what flavor do you want? Bubble gum? You're like, yeah. Okay. And you put this bubble gum flavor all over your teeth. But yeah, I do remember that. It's very strange. I wonder what that was now in retrospect.
Yeah, that was my biggest memory of going to the dentist as a kid. That gooey, globby stuff at the end of every session.
I remember two things about going to the dentist as a kid. One was that my dentist had a TV in her ceiling so that when we leaned back in the chair, we could watch the TV. So
oh,
that was
cool.
Pretty cool. Yeah. Although her hands and arms were blocking the TV most of the time. So that was cool. And I also remember that if you did a good job and didn't cry and were a big boy while you went to the dentist, you could choose a toy from this treasure chest that the dentist had. Mm-hmm. Actually, usually it wasn't a toy. It was like a toothbrush or some floss or something like that. So that wasn't very exciting, really. Exciting to choose the toy or exciting to choose the item, but not exciting once you saw what it was.
Better than nothing, right?
True.
There's one more thing I wanted to mention. I think, as listeners know, we live in Korea, and one interesting cultural difference between American dentists and Korean ones is that here, whether you're just getting your teeth cleaned or getting a cavity filled, doesn't matter. They're going to cover your eyes when they do it, like with a green tarp. But yeah, in America, they never did that.
Yeah, that is true. They cover your eyes up, which I actually like. I think that's kind of relaxing, like, because when you're in Canada and your eyes are, you can just look wherever, but it's kind of like, what do? I want to shut my eyes anyways, but then it feels strange. So yeah, I like that part of Korea. They cover up your eyes. And Kassy, I've also noticed that in Canada, the doctors hand out pain medication really easily. Like, even if it's just a minor thing, they'll numb you up.
Really?
Put you to sleep. Whatever you want.
Give you some laughing gas.
Yeah, give you some laughing gas. But here in Korea, they just go for it. And you gotta hope that you don't have too many problems, because when they pick around, it could be quite painful, I imagine.
Yeah, I'm curious how, you know, different procedures or protocols that they have in other countries around the world as well.
Yeah, absolutely. So, listeners, please get in touch and let us know about your experiences of going to the dentist. And thank you again to Dr. Alexandra, who requested this topic. And again, I apologize that we don't have a very positive outlook for you. I think that's maybe one of the things that a lot of dentists struggle with, is having to calm down and convince their clients and their patients that they'll be okay and that they're in good hands. So we'll leave it at here for today, but thank you for studying English with us today, everyone. What you just did right now is what you need to do to be fluent in English. So listening to English, spending some time with it every day. These are the things that will bring you success in your English learning. So we're glad that you showed up and put in some study time with us here today. And to recap this episode, Kassy, we talked about the fear of going to the dentist, and it sounds like we are both dentophobes to an extent.
I'm sure 95% of the world agrees with us.
If you enjoyed this episode, or maybe you didn't enjoy it, but you did find it educational or entertaining, well then, please consider supporting us. You could do that in a variety of ways, such as becoming a paid Culips member. And remember that you can sign up to become a member on our website, culips.com. Or you could tell your friends who are learning English to check us out and give Culips a listen. You could leave a 5-star rating and a positive review on your favorite podcast app, like Apple Podcasts. Or finally, you could follow us on social media, like Instagram, YouTube, Facebook, or Twitter. So that is it for us, but we'll be back soon with another brand new episode, and we'll talk to you then. Goodbye.
See ya.